Hello and a very warm welcome to the National Indoor Arena here in Birmingham for semi-finals day at the Yonex All England Badminton Championships. And what a lineup we've got for the semi-finals. We're starting with the world number one, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia. He's looking for his first All England title. He's up against the former champion Peter Gaeder of Denmark. Then men's doubles are Mathias Bo and Carsten Mogensen of Denmark, who defeated the holders and current world champions from China in yesterday's quarterfinal. They've got more Chinese opponents in Guo and Zhu. Then Saina Nehwal of India up against Tina Rasmussen of Denmark. She's trying to make it through to her third consecutive All England final. Then the second of the men's doubles, Lars Porsgaard and Jonas Rasmussen, former world champions, they're up against the current Olympic champions from Indonesia, Marcus Kido and Hendra Setiawan. Then the second of the men's singles, a youngster from Japan, Kenichi Tago, up against Bao Chun Lai from China, the left-handed player who defeated his teammate Lin Dan, the holder, in yesterday's quarterfinal. That was a big surprise. And then the last of our semi-finals this afternoon, mixed doubles and the Olympic champions Lee Yongdae and Lee Hojung up against Nova Widianto and Liliana Natsir, who've twice in the past been world champions. So when I say it's going to be a good lineup, I'm not underestimating that at all. It really is a terrific day's badminton here at the National Indoor Arena. So to our first match, and the number one seed Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia up against the number five seed Peter Gaeder from Denmark. So let's get on with the action. Let's get down courtside with our MC, Hilary Atkinson.
Please give a very warm welcome to Lee Chong Wei from Malaysia. Show your appreciation for his opponent from Denmark, Peter Gaeder.
Well, this should be a terrific match. Two of the biggest names in world badminton. Peter Gaeder, there he is, four times European champion. Former champion here, of course, at the All England way back in 1999, 11 years ago. And he's up against the current world number one, Lee Chong Wei. The Malaysian, this is a title that's eluded him. World number one now since the Olympic Games in Beijing, and he so desperately wants the All England title. And now the fact that Lin Dan, the holder and four times champion of the All England, defeated in yesterday's quarterfinal, I'm sure Lee Chong Wei must be believing that this could be his year. So both these players, tough quarterfinals yesterday evening, the quarterfinal encounters. But let's look first of all at the world number one. Well, Chetan Anand of India in the first round, and then Sonny Dwi Kunchoro of Indonesia. And don't underestimate the style in which he won that match, because Kunchoro was the Olympic bronze medalist back in 2004 and the World Championship silver medalist from 2007, and then in the quarterfinal against the qualifier Sean from Korea, dropped the opening game and then came back strongly in an hour and 1 minute. So certainly to beat the qualifier in the quarterfinal. What a start that youngster from Korea is going to be. But for Peter Gaeder, well, equally tough quarterfinal, this time against the number four seed, Taufik Hidayat of Indonesia. Had a game point in that opening game before losing it 20-22. Was 7-1 down in the second game and 8-1 down in the third game before coming back unbelievably strongly to take it in an hour and 20 minutes, 22-20 in that third and final game. What a thriller it was. It was badminton of the very, very highest quality. Peter Gaeder, 33 years of age, born in Aalborg in Denmark. And of course, I'm absolutely delighted to once again have with me Ian Wright, former head coach of the England badminton team. And of course, both these players, Ian, have had difficult matches yesterday, so equally tired, one would assume.
This is going to be a fascinating encounter. Very contrasting performances last night in the quarterfinals. Peter had to be at his absolute best against his old rival Taufik last night and produced a great performance to come through that. Whereas Lee Chong-wei was a little bit subdued against the qualifier from Korea, made a lot of uncharacteristic errors and will need to start a lot quicker today against Peter.
Yes, indeed. I was very, very impressed with that youngster from Korea, Seong Wan-ho. Really was delightful to watch. But the world number one, as you say, really didn't start as quickly as we would have expected him to start. But once he got into his rhythm, he really is delightful to watch. And as you say, I'm sure we'll talk about it a little bit more once the game gets underway. Contrasting styles. But Lee Chong-wei, when you think last year, 9 finals he was in, he won 7 of them. Previous year, 2008, he was in 8 finals. There's a very, very good reason why he is world number one. There's his coach, Misbahn Sadek. In fact, reached the final of the All England in Misbahn back in 1986, lost out to Morten Frost from Denmark. Very calm man is Misbahn Sadek. So as far as the coaching bench for Peter Gaeder is concerned, Kenny Jonasson in the white top there, please. Current European champion and former teammate, of course, of Peter Gaeder, and Lars Uhr, the head coach from Denmark. Real anticipation here for this men's singles semi-final. Well, so many people have been looking forward to this particular semi-final encounter. Lee Chong-wei against Peter Gaeder. Malcolm Bannon, our umpire from England. Lee Chong-wei, of course, the world number one, up against the world number five, Peter Gaeder. But former world number one, of course, because Peter Gaeder became world number one back in November 1997. He was just 20 years of age.
Lee Chong-wei, Malaysia. And on my left, Peter Gaeder, Denmark. Lee Chong-wei to serve. Love all. Play.
So the first of the semi-finals in the 100th All England Championships gets underway. That's short.
What's up?
Now, Ian, before semi-finals started, we were actually talking about the contrasting styles of these two men. Of course, Lee Chong-wei, one of the most naturally gifted athletes, I think, as far as physicality is concerned. I mean, his movement around the court is absolutely superb. And Peter Gaeder wants to be more aggressive within the rallies, doesn't he? He likes to command the rallies, in contrast.
Yes, I think in the first point we had a good example already of what Peter will be looking to do. He'll be looking to get control of the tempo of the game by controlling the net area. And there again we're seeing he's going for the short net return to give himself time with the attack.
Oh, that's lovely.
Service over.
Now, I have to ask the question.
What?
At the age of 33, when you've been on court for an hour and 20 minutes in your quarterfinal the night before, of course, Peter Gaeder is an incredible athlete himself, but surely. But, of course, when you get older, it's the recovery time that takes longer.
Yeah, Peter's a very professional player, and I'm sure he's done everything that he possibly can to be in the best condition after last night's match.
Strong's gone in with racket. It's interesting. We were talking to the Danish commentary team just before all these matches started, and they were saying, well, Peter Gaeder had said that in his quarterfinal, because he's been working physically so hard in preparation for the All England Championships, that he felt very comfortable and very confident in that third game, which is remarkable when you consider he was 8-1 down, that he still felt that he felt easy and he felt fit and he knew that he was going to come through.
I think he had a very, very strong idea of what he was trying to do tactically. And he backed himself in a difficult situation, but also there was a slight difference in ends last night. One end played a little bit quicker than the other, so he knew that it would be more difficult in the first half of the third game, and just kept his confidence up and kept fighting for the points, and just did enough in the first half of the game to keep himself in turning round to the end that was more suited to him.
Service over.
Wow. Peter Gaeder having a little look towards the line judge there.
Lee.
Oof. Goodness me. Well, it was called out.
Okay.
Umpire is only allowed to overrule the line judge. The umpire has seen that a clear error has been made, and quite frankly, when it's as close as that, can't tell if it's a clear error.
And that's the situation Peter will be wanting to avoid, giving Lee Chong Wei time to get behind the shuttle and use the big attack.
Oh my goodness. And of course, this is in reality a bit of a problem for Peter Gaeder, because Lee Chong Wei's court coverage phenomenally good. He gets so many shuttles back that he really works opponents. Opponents start to get frustrated that they're not hitting winners, and then they start going for winners that aren't on, trying to really hit the lines and so on. Gaeder has got to stay patient today.
He has, and I think we're seeing use a lot of variety, a lot of change of pace, change in direction, just to try and keep Chong Wei guessing a little bit, not let him get into a rhythm in defence.
This is the sixth time that these two players have met over the last. Yep. You have to go back to the Korean Open final in the beginning of 2009 for the last time that Peter Gaeder won, because the other four matches played last year were won by the Malaysian.
And that's the danger you were talking about, Jill. Peter feeling he'd got to really play with a low margin there to try and win the point, and just made the mistake.
Peter Gaeder sent in the wrong direction, managed to recover, and didn't just recover, he got it back with interest.
6-4.
Coaches look very relaxed, the Danish coaches.
I think they'll be trying to keep Peter relaxed, not letting him waste too much nervous energy early in the match. Just keep him nice and relaxed and just see how the match unfolds in the first 11 points before the first coaching interval.
Completely mistimed that one.
Five,
of course, I'm sure both these athletes will be putting themselves under enormous pressure. As far as the Dane is concerned, he must be thinking, age of 33, my number of chances I've got left to win the All England for a second time, very few, I would think. This must be his best chance of one final All England title. And of course, as far as the Malaysian is concerned, it's taken an awful lot of stick in the Malaysian press about the fact that he hasn't won one of the big majors, he hasn't won the World Championships, didn't win the Olympic Games, beaten in the All England final last year.
Yes, the mental side of this game will be very interesting. It's difficult to say who's under the most pressure. Peter's actually won it before, so he can take confidence from that, but he knows he hasn't got many more chances to get another title here. Whereas Lee Chong Wei is clearly under pressure to win and follow some of the great Malaysian names of the past who've won this title.
No serve is called good. Landed on the line. Yeah, it certainly did. That's a lovely no serve.
Again, Peter looking to get control of the net there, looking for the net roll to get the lift, to win a bit more time with the attack.
It's me. Angles. That's where he's really known, his quality of finding those steep, steep angles.
Yeah, and great variety. One straight, one cross, using the full width of the court there after taking control of the rally with the good net shot.
Now, Ian, one aspect of men's singles that I think has changed dramatically, maybe over the last decade, but certainly in recent times, is the fact that they all serve backhand now and serve low the majority of the time. It used to be the case that virtually all serves in singles were big high serves right to the back of the court. Just to explain to us why that has changed and how the game has developed.
I think there's a number of reasons. I mean, the game, since it became the sport of badminton, when it became an Olympic sport, the physicality has increased substantially during the last decade or so. So the players now, they're all capable of hitting very, very big, high jump smashes, getting the shuttle down low and playing a very, very aggressive game. So the physicality has increased. But also with this scoring system, getting the first chance to attack is absolutely crucial. It's become very, very important. There used to be periods under the old scoring system where you could relax a little bit, play the rallies out, be more patient, but now with every point counting, it's too crucial to give your opponent easy opportunities to get into the rally.
So hence, you don't want to lift the shuttle from the start, you just want to hit the low serve. Chong Wei doesn't like the call.
Seven.
Well, we've got a very good view of that line from where we're sitting. Oof, yeah. Not convinced now. I have to say, the line judges, they volunteer their time. I would hate to be a line judge because you have to make all these very, very close calls and you have to make your decision instantaneously. So I do think in general terms they do a very good job. Oh, that's good.
You're absolutely right, Jill. It was a great example last night in Peter's game against Taufik. 20 all in the third set. Taufik leads the shuttle at the back and there's a fraction, an absolute fraction, and the match is won or lost on those sorts of calls. So they are under pressure, these lines people, as volunteers.
Oh yes, that's nice. Finds the line. Malaysian fans delight in that. Kept it so flat over the net.
Starting to see this is going to be a real tough mental and physical battle here. Peter's match last night was an extremely long match, but he must have taken confidence from being able to finish such a close match. But he's going to be tested to the limit physically here by Chong Wei, who is one of the great athletes in the world today.
258 kilometers an hour. That's about 161 miles per hour. Extraordinary. What a drop shot. Jumping back in court. And so his body weight was going back, and yet he still had the racket head control to play the most glorious drop shot. That is sensational. Some four straight points from the Malaysian actors going into the margins.
Jeg kan ikke rigtig komme ind og slå de der smashlinger.
Men du skal sørge for at komme langt frem, for der kommer ikke en farlig
sætte.
Der hvor de kommer til de andre, det er fra forbanen.
I can't remember Lee Chong Wei playing one at the net at the moment.
No, I think it's going to be a big area of this game. I'm sure Misville's mentioned that to Chong Wei in the break, that the danger with Peter, if Peter can get control of the net, he'll be able to control the tempo of the match. Whereas Lee Chong Wei will be wanting a slightly higher tempo match to try and impose more a more physical type of game.
Play.
What a good net return. Good aggression, isn't it? Very good.
It's very, very good. Very, very good early net reply there. Winning time with the attack, and then great variety and great angles with the attack to finish.
61 major international titles these two have won between them. It's phenomenal, isn't it? Peter Gaeta, 35 titles.
So, we saw that.
The 100th All England has really pulled everybody out. This is actually technically the strongest tournament that we've seen in the world of badminton since the Beijing Games. Every one of the top world-ranked players is here this week, and it's the first time everybody's been together in a tournament since those Olympic Games.
Oh, that is superb, isn't it? Do you think that against a player like Lee Chong Wei, perhaps Peter Gaeta is in danger of overplaying the cross-court angles? Because he's really looking for it now, isn't he? I mean, he really anticipated that one.
Yeah, but I think there's a fine line for Peter. He's got to use a lot of variety. If he doesn't, Lee Chong Wei will just sit back and be able to defend and keep the rallies going. Peter's really got to take one or two calculated risks here.
How does he do that? That's unbelievable. It's fantastic.
14-11.
Well, that's why he's the world's best player at the moment. I mean, he's got great touch from everywhere. Everybody talks about his physicality, but technically as well, he can produce any shot from any position on the court.
Yes, and I think that not only that, I think that perhaps myself and others, and especially myself, was a little bit critical of him about 3 or 4 years ago. I thought he was a bit passive in his style of play. He used to just sit back and wait to react whatever his opponent was doing. I think he's got a new dimension to his game. Working with Misbahn Sadek, he's now able to inject pace of movement and pace of shot.
Yes, I think he's got such respect for Misbahn. He's more than just a coach to him, he's a real mentor, and they've got a very, very strong relationship. And when things are going wrong for Lee Chong Wei, you'll see him looking to Misbahn and Misbahn calming him down. It's a very, 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 very positive relationship that they have.
You see, he's so eager to really put pressure on the net that Peter Gaeder now is struggling with those net shots. And as you say, that's the vital part of Gaeder's game.
Yes, I think that's been the change since the coach. And I'm sure Misbahn was talking to Chong Wei about not letting Peter get early on the net. And we've seen Chong Wei getting a little bit earlier and really starting to compete for that net control. And that's been the difference since the break. In the first, up until the coaching break, Lee Chong Wei was happy to just lift out after Peter was playing net. Now he's competing, playing the second net shot and not giving them Peter control of the net.
Look how he had to let that come out of the spin, out of the tumble, and therefore he was taking it so late. And as you've rightly pointed out, he now has that touch and control. No, hasn't that changed? You're right, since the mid-game interval, didn't have any winners at the net prior to that.
Service over. 12-17.
You see that little run of 6 points, that's the sort of thing that I think that now Lee Chong Wei has added to his game. Suddenly the intensity for six rallies, and it's made a phenomenal difference to the game. 17-12 up now.
As a young player, he certainly had the tendency to go through phases of matches where he would be very, very passive. And I'm sure they've worked a lot on that. And he's now much more proactive in the choices that he makes in the middle of the sets.
So hard for that rally.
And again there we're seeing a lot more exchanges at the net. 17. One net, two nets. Real fight now going on to who can get control of the front court.
The Liverpool fan is Peter Gaeder. When's Liverpool's next match? Portsmouth, isn't it? I think it's Portsmouth on Monday night. He'll be watching that.
Thank you.
Oh, sellout for today's matches and, of course, for the finals tomorrow. Pushed it long. Well, Gaeta was coming back after being down in yesterday's quarterfinal against Taufik Hidiak. You'll have the belief he can do it again.
He showed great resilience last night in that match, and he's got to have taken a lot of confidence from that match.
Oh, yes. You can't tell with his overhead which way it's going to go. Lee Chong Wei can hit down the line or cross court as he did in that situation. Look how he transfers the body weight as well. As soon as he's landed, he's already moving back towards the centre of the court, towards his base position. And he's now just 2 points away from this opening game. Just tiny. Four game points now to the world number one. And it's well saved. When the net shot works, the previous rally, it was a fraction away from being a perfect net call, but ended up an error. That time, it was perfection. Anticipated so well, did Lee Chong Wei.
First game won by Lee Chong Wei, 21-17.
Smashes the shuttle across court, and the reaction from Peter Gaeta. Bit of disappointment, I'm sure he thought it was absolutely vital to win this opening game, but it hasn't happened because the world number one, Lee Chong Wei, has taken it 21-17.
Rapat-rapat dekatnya, itu saja. Lain semua biasa. Ya, jangan respect dia apa-apa. Dia tak ada apa-apa. Pusul tak ada apa. Dia cuma nak kacau juga.
Well, that's interesting. Malaysian hitting 8 of his 12 winning shots towards the Gaeta forehand side. The Dane pressurising his opponent's backhand side. Something you would have suspected beforehand?
Really, I think both of them are using great variety with the attack, and they're both, when they're getting control of the net and winning the attack, they're both hitting the straight and the cross attacks to keep their opponent guessing as to where they're going. I think we might possibly see Peter go to the centre a little bit in this second game with the attack, just to keep Chong Wei, to stop Chong Wei anticipating, because Chong Wei's starting to, as you said earlier, Jill, he's starting to read that cross court attack a little bit, so it might be good if Peter uses the centre a little bit just to break that up.
Both players taking on board the advice of coaches, I'm sure.
Court 2, 20 seconds. Court 2, 20 seconds.
Concerning, Ian, the fact that the Dane, Peter Gaeder, at the end of that opening game, he looked at his body language, he sort of bent over double, second he was game. Frustrated with himself. Does that concern you?
Peter's a player who always puts a lot of pressure on himself. He's a perfectionist. And last night we felt at the same stage when he dropped the first set to Taufik, maybe he was in trouble. It was going to be hard for him to come back. But he showed great resilience mentally last night. And I'm sure this match isn't over yet.
That's a wonderful angle. That's what you were talking about, Ian. He's got to take the calculated risk when you've got the lift, which he had there. Then he's going to go for his angles.
Against Chong Wei, you need great precision, and Peter's just demonstrated that there. But when you're playing that sort of game, of course you're going to make one or two mistakes, but you've got to be mentally strong and stick with your game plan.
Don't see too many errors like this from Lee Chong Wei. Do you think he changed his mind there? Possibly. Was presumably what he was trying to do at a previous rally, launching himself towards the net, and because he's coming from above the shuttle, he's got so many options.
Yes, as the match has gone on, it's clear that Chong Wei's brought his base a long way up the court. He's playing a lot higher up the court to give Peter less time to get the net shot in.
Again, the precision and the touch at the net is just phenomenal.
Three,
and it's combined
two.
With such great agility, the physical agility of both players. We see Peter there, down on his knees, his back, and only just missing with the tape there.
Peter?
Good flick serve. Oh, he's found the line.
4-2.
And the occasional change of serve there, Ian, as he started that rally with a flick, just keeps opponents on their toes.
Yeah, and it's just showing Peter, if he's going to use the flick, it just makes Peter hesitate a little bit, hang back a little bit, not take it as early so he can't get that tight net shot in off the short serve.
Quite frankly, I think the domination from the front of the court from the Malaysian is the deciding factor.
Yes, and this is a different Chong Wei to the Chong Wei we watched in the quarterfinal last night. His concentration level's very high. He's cut out the uncharacteristic easy mistakes he was making in his quarterfinal match last night. And this is going to be a really, really tough battle for Peter from now on.
Do you know, it was the first half of the first game where Peter Gaeder had those two winners from the front of the net. Since then, total domination by the Malaysian. Good kill at the net, good anticipation.
service over.
There we see Peter's having to force, he's having to play with such a small margin of error that there's one or two errors are beginning to creep in at the front of the court, because he knows Chong Wei's brought that base forward so much that there's much less time and space for him to use his net shots.
As he played that defensive shot, he didn't seem to have a back swing, he didn't seem to have a follow through, and yet he still managed to guide that across court. That's just extraordinary.
Yeah, and great anticipation. Li Chongwei sees the shuttle so early and his anticipation is so good, and when you combine that with his physical ability, it's a tough combination to break down.
Well, Li Chongwei looking towards the umpire, almost appealing without verbalising it, just asking the question, did Gator take that before it went over the net? No. Good umpire. Serve, I think, from Li Chongwei.
Yeah, and again there we can see how desperate Peter is to look for the early return off the short serve and then getting caught out by the flick. He knows he's under pressure to get early on the short serve return and play the net, and just getting caught out there.
Oh, yes. Makes it look so easy.
10-5.
Look at this movement. Just seems to glide back in court and then the explosive leap in the air.
Service over.
That time, Nadine absolutely six, alert to the flick ten. Serve. Just delightful to watch when you see Li Chongwei flowing like this. It won't please the Danish fans. I think they'll be feeling very anxious at the moment. And in all honesty, Ian, I'm not sure what Peter Gader can do at the moment. How is he going to break down his opponent?
Well, that's the danger now. He's lost that control of the net, that he's having to flick off the net and play to the rear court, and that's where Chongwei is at his most dangerous. When he can get up and intercept the shuttle early and hit the powerful angles, it's very, very difficult to defend against. So I think what Lars will be saying is that Peter's got to find ways to open the court up to try and create some space at the front court, maybe to use a few more cross blocks, to force Chongwei off the straight lines, just to break the game a little bit and maybe get some more time to control the net.
So
a 5-point advantage in this second game. The world number one. Just wide.
There he's over.
Good patience from Peter there. Just slowing the game down a little bit, and Chongwei doesn't really like a lack of pace in the game. He likes a good high rhythm, and Peter's just slowed it down there a little bit.
Seven.
Just incredible. No wonder they're happy.
12-7. Service over. 8-12.
And there, Peter, just using a little bit of deception there, rather than just going in and playing the next shot, just holding it a little bit, just trying to create a little bit of uncertainty for Chong Wei and winning the error.
He is so fast. The smash from the back of the courts knew that it was a good smash and therefore that the reply had to be straight. And he's in so quickly, is Li Chongwei. 261 kilometres an hour. It's 162 miles per hour.
Service over.
Oh, just proving that he too can go quickly into the net, Peter Gaider.
That's super play, great 10, anticipation. 30. Not the raw speed of Li Chongwei, but super anticipation and super construction of the point there to create the space. Great play.
We talked about it yesterday, Ian, when a player comes forward to the net and they're coming with their racket from on top of the shuttle 40, rather than coming 10. Underneath. They have so many options. Here he comes in. He can hold it and then brush it straight down that line.
Yeah, technically, Li Chongwei is a great example to any young players watching. His racket's always ready, always in a ready position. You don't see the racket down by his knees at any point. He's always looking to take the shuttle early, and the racket carriage is really exceptional.
Service over. 11-14.
Don't see many of those, do we? Error on serve. Needed, it doesn't get closer than that. That shuttle seemed to sit on top of the net for an age before it went over. Oh, that is brilliant.
That's the famous Peter Gade net touch.
Thank you, Peter.
As a young player, he used to spend hours playing net singles with his coach, his early coach that he had for many years, Michael Kelson. They used to play every spare time they were playing net singles, and he's built up such a great touch around that area over the years.
Short. And they can't afford to do that against the world number one, because He will take those opportunities. Look where his feet are landing, well inside the doubles service line at the back of the court, and therefore the opportunity to play the winning smash. Well, fastest smash of the match so far, 262. Just wide.
13-15.
So close, isn't it?
Certainly been the big turning point in this game. Lee Chong-wei cutting Peter's time 30. Down at the net. That's a good net shot Peter's played there, but Lee Chong-wei's all over it.
Looked a slightly nervous shot to me. I think perhaps the fact that last time he had lifted or tried to lift deep into the Malaysian's forehand corner, it got severely thumped. Maybe as he was playing the shot, changing his mind, that's why he made the error. And he's still trying to pressurize that deep forehand.
This time, great variety from Chong Wang, not forcing the cross-court attack, slowing the cross-court attack down, setting up the opportunity for the straight smash. Super 18, play, he looks in a real high rhythm now.
Yes, and once again, he's opened up a five-point cushion, and quite frankly, only needing another 3 points to secure his place in his second consecutive All-England final. It's a tall, tall order now for this Dane.
Very, very difficult for Peter now, because he's already been playing with very small margins, and now he needs a little bit of help from Chong Wei, I feel, to get back into this match. If Chong Wei keeps it solid from here, it's difficult to see how Peter can take the points off him that he needs to do.
Yeah, it's lovely. It's quite incredible, because it's almost as if he thinks to himself, yeah, well, my opponent's caught up a little, right, I'm just going to up the pace, and it seems to be able to win points at will. Most people have to work and work and work, but he suddenly turns it on and says, right, okay, hit a few lines, hit a few winners. He's able to do that.
His decision making is very good at the moment. The last two rounds we've seen great examples. Slower cross court attack to set up the opportunity for the straight attack, and full cross court attack. Very, very difficult for Peter 14, to defend 19. Against variety of that nature.
Peter Gaeta brought to his knees, metaphorically and physically. Well, just brilliant from the Malaysian. And after 45 minutes of action, he's on the verge of his second All England final. Beaten finalist last year to Lin Dan. Six match points. That'll do. Lee Chong-wei gave a demonstration today of exactly why he is the world number one. Great respect for each other as players, these two men, and any
Malaysian fans who perhaps were a little bit concerned as to the way Lee Chong Wei played yesterday. No such concerns today. He was absolutely superb. And as far as Peter Gaydar is concerned, as Lee Chong Wei gets congratulated by his coach, well, Peter Gaydar's had a wonderful All England, as always. But I just wonder whether this has been the end of a dream. The opportunity may never come again at the age of 33. He's had a great tournament. Look at the look on his face. And that, to me, says it all. So, confirmation of the score. 21-17, 21-14. And Lee Chong Wei is in the final of the Onyx All England Championships.
Thank you.